Hi guys, and welcome to the Battle for Azeroth dungeon exploration. So in today's video I'll be doing the new released Shrine of the Storms dungeon. So currently you can't queue up for this on the alpha in any of the dungeons, so the only way to get here is with the dungeon teleporter, and then I'm going to try and find a way to get through till the end and show off all the bosses and the models. So currently, as soon as you load in, you're greeted with the new Rexxar model. With the power of the Tide Pearl, our fleets will be unstoppable. The Alliance must not claim this prize. All who oppose us will fail. Now let the hunt begin. So it seems we're getting a Tide Pod XD, or a Tide Pearl. So it seems the way to go is out here. So as you can see, it's got to do with trolls, but there's water people here. So maybe Kul Tiras, because he's got some Kul Tiras armor on. So as you can see, they're definitely water people. Temple attendant. As you can see, it looks like, yeah, it's like facing out into the sea. So the first boss is Aquasia. So it seems that there's some of these guys empowering the living current. I'm surprised they didn't give a new model for these type of elementals, because they've added in quite a few new elemental models apart from that one. As you can see, all these water guys, all these globules. Let's try and go to the first boss. As you can see, there's definitely an urge for water. Is that the first boss? Lord Stormstrong. That just seems to be the third boss, but I don't think he's attackable. Or is he? Seems as though he's got something on his head. Let's see if we can... Ah, so when you get close, he sees you. How dare you silly with this place with your presence. So, he must... Yeah, call upon the surging waters. So let's see what spawns. I'm going to just quickly sneak past, just in case it locks me out with a gate or something like that. So as you can see, yeah, that's got a new model. So I think in the future they might add that model to the rest, but as you can see, it got a really, really cool model. I just quickly snuck past in case there was a gate blocking me, but it doesn't seem there is. But they should add one, so people can't just run past. Just quickly get past these guys. So this go into this little cave. Rune Scarver Sorn. Is that a boss? No, it's just a guy over the new Kul Tiras models. See, these guys also have the Kul Tiras armor and the weapons. Let's quickly sneak past this guy. So the next boss is Tide Sage Council. So as you see, yeah, this is the council.
Just in time to witness true power.
So it seems a lot of ads we got to kill. So there's two bosses here. So it's not really council, it's more a duo. So it seems Rexxar might join us here, because you can see his text popping up. Just see what happens if we skip them. Let's go into this next bit. So Deep Sea Ritualist. Just see what happens if we avoid them. It's weird that these guys, them hammers from Naxxramas. Seems there's these enforcers. As we get deeper in. Depthbringer. Something seems off, shifting disguise. So let's see what's up here. Abyssal Cultist, Shifting Geist, Sphinx. Ah, so the thing which is off is that they're all corruptors. Aha. So this is, as you can see, Queen Ajar. And there's Lord Stormsong. He's actually a Abyssal. So if we just quickly sneak past him.
Uh-huh. It would seem you have guests, Lord Stormsong.
So what happens if we just quickly sneak past this guy? I think you have to... What's this? Get out of that so I don't get take boy damage. Or else he'll see me. Let's see if we can find a way. So is there like a jump down? Find it. So is there like, would he put in a teleporter here? Or, okay. Not sure where this leads. And instantly died. So yeah, it seems as though you can't get to the last boss because you have to open up a teleporter, which means you have to kill Lord Stormsong, which currently you can't. So yeah. And that's it for the shrine. So as you can see, there's there's the quest line for Quinajara and stuff like that to come. But yeah, let's go outside this one and see where it's set. See if it's set in Horde or Alliance territory. Shrine of the Storm, Stormsong Valley. So it seems that this is a Horde location since it's got all this Horde flight paths. So yeah, Zanilar. So it's in Kul'Tiras at the very, very top. So yeah, that's it for the Shrine of the Storms. So yeah, I've got videos up on all the other dungeons which they've just released, so check them out if you want to see them, and see you in the next one.